people are getting back to work, there is still something that is not so quick to bounce back, and that is your credit score.
Yeah, when you think about it, it really impacts everything from your ability to borrow money to your ability to get an apartment. And if it goes too low, you could spend years trying to build it back up. Tonight, Jocelyn Howard is on your side. She spoke with an expert on the best ways to boost your rating.
I feel like I've been stuck in this spiral.
Christina Brown has spent years trying to build her credit score to buy a house. When she lost her job and racked up months of debt, her score went south.
COVID just completely destroyed that dream.
Kenneth Mayfield says his credit score dropped
about 300 points
after getting in an accident during the pandemic and was unable to pay medical bills.
I was nearing 700, and so now I'm back in the 400s.
Financial stability manager Sonia Fleshman says she's seen so many of those struggling during the pandemic fall down a slippery slope.
You start with late payments and, you know, it can escalate, you know, to eviction, foreclosure,
which makes credit scores
take a nosedive.
And it takes a long time to recover. Fleshman says the first steps are to stabilize and save.
Only pay the necessities and pay the necessities first. Your mortgage and your rent comes first.
Then maintain good credit habits. Pay bills on time and pay them off in full. Keep accounts open and active, making occasional purchases on them and paying them off right away. Also know just what is going into your credit score.
During the pandemic, we can actually monitor our credit for free on a weekly basis.
You can visit annualcreditreport.com where you can see all of the information that's collected about you that impacts your score. And if you find something in your report that's not right, you can start the process to clear it up. And that will make a difference in raising your score. Jocelyn Howard, First Coast News, on your side.